this section we are going to start to outline, which I did right here. You can see I outlined over all my pencil lines with a fine point Sharpie, and now I'm going to start adding some color. You can use oil pastels. I have the Portfolio water soluble oil pastels that are great to use, or you can use any other regular type of oil pastel, such as these. And we're going to start out first by creating some darker areas with the black pastel. And I'm just going to color around some of these edges where I outlined with the black pen and make some of these areas a little more shadowed. And once I add that black on, I'm going to smooth it out, make it look more like a shadow. So I'm going to take a Q-tip or a cotton swab and give that a nice soft feathered look. You can give some of this out more into the contour shape. And this heart helps to start give it some of that shadow, which creates more of a curve on it. Do this between the other areas that are connecting. I can pull that out, start to give it a little bit of contour. I'm making some cross contour lines with the black pastels. And if you get too much, it's a bit of crumble, just take a tissue or a paper towel and wipe the end off. You can see by just going like this back and forth across in the same direction as my cross contour lines are going, I'm actually creating more cross contour lines with the soft look of the pastel. And that really helps to give it a nice depth effect. And I'm going to do this throughout the entire thing, but just to show you now where I add the color. And if you'd like, you can just continue to do with the black and keep it a black and white image. But if it needs color, you choose some colors that will look nice up against each other. I'm going to start with a red this time, and I'm going to do the same thing right along the line where I already placed the black. I'm going to color back and forth in the same direction as the cross contours and make this come out just a little bit farther than that black line. Continue to blend this together to give it a nice solid look and also soften that edge, make it look more feathered. You might have to press down a little, give a little pressure on it. The other end on this side, but I'm going to just add a little bit coming out on this side as well to help give it some more curve. If you remember when we did the cylinder, we kept a lighter area down through the center of the cylinder so that it made it look more rounded. So I'm going to do the same idea here. Blend that in. And then just continue to go back and forth with the cotton swab. Next one. continue doing red and green, and I'm going to create a pattern with colors, and end up with something like this. And that's when I use green, purple, and blue, so three colors to repeat. And I just made sure that they were not touching each other throughout.